Hi, it's Steve. In this video, we'll discuss some of the reasons why the buttons on your microwave may not be working. We'll look at the components involved and how to test them. Now, there are two components that are involved with the buttons on your microwave: the actual touchpad or membrane switch on the face and the control board, which is located in behind. The touchpad is actually a series of switches that send signals to that control board. The first thing to check would be the individual pads on that touchpad, looking for any signs of damage or deterioration. If any is noted, you'll need to replace that touchpad. If there is no visible damage to that touchpad, you can check it with a multimeter, but you will need the manufacturer's wiring diagram for the touchpad and the ability to interpret that data to check it with a multimeter. Now, if you suspect that the touchpad is working properly, our next step would be to look at the control board. First of all, verify that the connection between that membrane switch and the control board is secure, but we'll also look for any signs of corrosion at that connection point. If any is found, you can suspect that the control board is defective. Also look for any signs of arcing or burning on that control board, and if any is found, again, you will need to replace that control board. To troubleshoot the control board any further, you will need to have and be able to interpret the manufacturer's wiring information for that particular model. Need help with anything else around your home? Search our channel for thousands of helpful videos that will walk you through your home repairs. For more information or the parts needed for these repairs, don't forget to check out PartSelect.com. Thank you so much for watching this video, and remember to subscribe so you don't miss a thing.